Hi friends, this is our second lecture on of superstition by Francis Bacon and 18th essay in our series, 18th essay. Total there are 50 essays, this is the 18th one. So let's begin. Sentence 1, if it were better to have no opinion of God at all than such an opinion as is unworthy of Him. We don't know anything much about God. So what people do is they make their own opinions. Some gods they assign to, say, we can say, manager of snakes, another manager of droughts, another manager of epidemics, another manager of rain and so on. So they say that is, it's better not to have such opinions. Because such opinions are unworthy of Him. Again, he is the head of as people say, ministry like that. So that is an unworthy opinion. So it's better not to have opinion than to have unworthy opinion about God. For the one is unbelief. If you have no opinion about God, if you are not concerned about God, that is unbelief, or you can say atheism. Atheism. Theism means belief in God. Atheism is belief in God. Pantheism, you know, that you have got vessel. Pantheism. Pan means all. As a Greek prefix means pan. Pandemonium. All confusion. Milton uses that in Paradise Lost. Pandemonium. Pan-American. It's all American. Now here what is this? Atheism. Theism means no belief in God. That is. So the one is unbelief. The other is condemning. Condemning means abusive language. You are using abusive language against God when you are having bad opinion on unworthy opinion of God. Opinions which are unworthy of God. So that is condemning or abusive language. If you say, if you call, suppose you don't say, don't make any remark about teacher, it's quite wrong. Teacher, you are normal. Suppose you go around calling him bad name, nickname, and criticizing him unnecessarily. That is a reproach, actually. It's an attack on the teacher. It is just like that. Certainly, condemnably, and certainly, superstition is a reproach of the deity. Reproach means an attack on the deity, superstition. See, there are many superstitions, you know. So something you know, one superstition very common is trichidescaphobia. Trichi means three. Deca means 10. Phobia means your fear or hatred, isn't it? Trichi 3, 10, hatred. So then hatred, or you can say fear of number 13. Fear, some people are alerted to number 13 in a hotel or a hostel, they will run away from there. That is superstition. Yes. Plutarch. We have come across him in our essay on many of his essays here. Or Fortune. That's a reference to Plutarch. Many of Bacon's essays you will find reference to Plutarch. Plutarch was a Greek biographer, Platonist philosopher and essayist. He wrote the stories of noble Greeks and noble Romans. What is popularly known as parallel lives. Why parallel lives? Because he is pairing means takes one from Rome and one from Greece, and then he compares. For example, in the case of Pompey and Agesilaus, he was Spartan king, and he is compared to Pompey, the Roman leader, Pompey. Pompey is as great as we can say Caesar, but of course in the power struggle, he lost, Pompey lost. Pompey and Agesilaus. Agesilaus is Spartan king. Spartan means Greek. Spartan. And Pompey of Rome. Roman. So this is how he wrote the biographies of noble Greeks and noble Romans, popularly known as parallel lives. So what did Plutarch say? Remember Plutarch's lives, lives of these noblemen. There are the second important book during the Middle Ages. In the Middle Ages and also the beginning of during Renaissance also. Plutarch was rediscovered and translated into almost all the important languages of the world. So Plutarch, his lives has that, as we consider the Bible, you know, the secular world considers or gives importance to Plutarch's lives. So Plutarch seemed well to that purpose. To that purpose means what I have already made, that statement I made. What is that? Superstition is a reproach, attack. Then it's better to be atheist rather than using bad language towards God or describing God. And what does he say? He says, surely say thee, I had rather a great deal of men should say there was no such man at all as Plutarch. He says, I'll be very happy if people would say that I never lived. I'll be very happy. But then that they should say that there was one Plutarch that would eat his children as soon as they were born. That will be, what do you call, contumely. That is abusive language using to refer to a person, Plutarch. So yeah, therefore he says, I would be very happy people say that I never lived. Then to say that, I was such a person that as soon as children are born to me, I will eat them. There are some beliefs like that, some gods they do like that. And in stories, probably you might have read it. As the poet speaks of Saturn. Saturn, you know, S-A-T-U-R. So that is considered to be, there's some blemish in Saturn. You are under the power of Satan. That means you will undergo a lot of suffering. That's what people think of Satan. So people say bad things about Satan. Satan is a god. So like that, it were better that if people would say that I never lived, rather than saying things like this, that is using abusive language to refer to me, that whenever my children are born to me, I will eat them as soon as they are born. So this is what people say about the God Saturn. And the contumely is greater towards God. So the danger is greater towards man. That is the point. When you are using abusive language to refer to a God, what are you doing? You are also creating problems for human beings in this world. Danger to men. If you use abusive language to refer to God, then naturally what will happen? You will use abusive language towards men also. So that became great problems in our society. Atheism leaves a man to sense. So what are the positive effects of atheism? Means if you have no belief in God, then what will you do? You will depend on your sense. Otherwise, everything you look up, this is God's punishment. This is God's blessing. This is the way do God works. This is God's providence. So we have your own sense. So let me reason to philosophy. If you are atheist, then you will hold on to philosophy to explain this natural phenomena. To natural piety, means you will start the respecting natural powers, that is natural piety, and that is virtual pantheism, seeing God in every created thing, to laws, to rules of the society, to reputation. That means you will do good things for your good name, reputation, all of which may guide all of which may be guides to an outward moral virtue. All of which means what? Your reason, your philosophy, your natural piety, your laws, your reputation. This will, in a way, help you to lead a naturally moral life. Moral virtue. Outward moral virtue. That means a decent, law-abiding citizen. If you are an atheist. Otherwise, you will always look up. Atheist. And then, though religion were not. That's the way. So, religion depends on this belief in God. Even though there are people who are so meticulously following the rules and regulations of religion, they may not be leading a good civil life. That's what if you read the history of the Jews, you'll find they are so meticulously following rules. Legalism dominated their lives, but not good life. That's why Jesus, answering the questions of who is my neighbor, he narrates the story of the Good Samaritan. The Good Samaritan, that's the thing. So that is what he called a moral virtue, an outward moral virtue, though religion were not. Religion, what happens very often, there will be fanaticism will get in, and that will lead to quarrels, fights, and maybe wars of the crusades. No, like that, there are many, not only wars of the crusades. In the course of history, you will find all religions, you will find some people who are interested in fighting, warring people you will find, warring groups you will find. So that's what he says, though religion we are not. But superstition dismounts all this, throws away everything, throws away rules of nature, moral behavior, and that is moral virtues, outward moral virtues, religion also, and then dismounts and throws. Superstition throws out all this. That is atheism and theism. All those things connected with atheism and theism. Wow. And then what will happen? And for this, all those erecting means creating a structure, erecting a building, creating a structure erected, an absolute monarchy. Absolute there. Superstitions have absolute opinions, absolute monarchy in the minds of men. Theism is comparatively good because it is natural. Theism, that is, you find embedded in religions, may not help you to lead a life of virtue. But both this will be thrown out when superstition comes in. Because superstition has now Krishna looking right side or left side, but only one side, and that is just one opinion, absolute opinion. Number 13, you have to be afraid. You see a black cat, it's a bad woman. Sorry, black cat is a bad woman. So this is, there is fixed and superstition. That way it is fixed, that is, it throws out your good things connected with atheism, good approaches, and also with religion. This is the problem with the... It is fixed in the minds of men. You can't change it. It is, you can say, maybe it is culture, maybe it is custom, maybe it is tradition, whatever you call it, but certain things are in me and in you also, isn't it? Certain superstitions. Therefore, atheism will never perturb state. Perturb means create a problem. create confusion, perturbation. Perturb means to confuse things. But, or did not give rise to any quarrels. Disturb, perturb means disturb states. For it makes men weary of themselves as looking no further. Because when you don't have a deity or you don't believe in anything supernatural, then you look around. Like your reason, your philosophy, your natural piety, your respect for nature, your own loss made by you, and see reputation that you would be getting when you obey these rules, etc. So with that you are satisfied, not looking no further. And we see the times inclined to atheism, means the times of atheism, that when atheism prevailed in this world, as the time of Augustus Caesar in Rome, were civil times, peaceful times. There will be no war, peaceful times, atheism. Because when the moment you get theism and religion, then what happens is that the fanaticism will grow. And this fanaticism will lead to fights. And that fight will create disturbance in the state. For example, in Rome, during the time of Augustus Caesar, there was no such disturbance. And we have seen that there was tremendous growth of art and art, then you can see literature and fine arts and all those things. Because Augustan age, we say now, Augustan age, that word comes from Augustus Caesar. The prosperity that they gained during the time of Augustus Caesar, that's because that was the period of atheism in Rome. That is what Bacon says. Okay. But superstition had been the confusion of many states, and bring it in a new premium mobile that ravisheth all spheres of government. So when you have got superstition rules a state, or superstition is a leader or a king or a minister or a rulers are ruled by superstitions, then what will happen is that becomes number one premium mobile. That ravish means that gets hold of all spheres of government. So you have to wait to start a project, you have to wait for a particular time. What do you call an auspicious time? To end a project, you have to wait for that. Then all the results you will ascribe to that a particular situation. So some failure that will be also be attributed to some situations. So then what happens? There is a lot of confusion. That's what he said. The master of superstition is the people. And in all superstitions, wise men follow fools. Underline that. In all superstitions, wise men follow fools. The arguments are fitted to practice in a reversed order. Reversed order means actually what should happen is first there should be principle and then practice. First there should be principles and then you practice. But in this case it is not like that. Start practice and then you lay down principles. That is reversed order. For example, you know, there is the story of a saintly man who used to conduct puja every day. Probably you might have come across that. And once or twice it happened that a cat came, ran through that platform where he was supposed to conduct the puja. And then a third time the rat did the same thing. So the wise man, he tied the cat nearby pole. There's a practice. After Sunday what happened? Those people who continued conducting worship or pujas and so on. They thought, to start a puja or a worship, first of all you have to bring a cat and tie it on the platform. Otherwise, the puja or the or the worship will not be complete. So here what happened? First the practice, then the theory. theory comes later. First, yes, sir. And it all happened accidentally, we know that. From the story, we understand that it's so happening. A cat disturbed him, so he tied it down to a pole. And then those people who came after, say, years after, they thought that to start ending like this, there must be a cat, and the cat should be tied to a pole. So that is reversed order. Practice first, principle next. But the order is principle first, practice next. So this is what happens to most of the superstitions that we entertain in our day-to-day life. So to sum up, we say, can we say in this part, the sentence 1 to 8, what Bacon is trying to tell us is that it's better to have no opinion about God rather than having bad opinions about God. No opinion is unbelief for atheism. Having bad opinion is a reproach or contumely. Contumely means you are using abusive language towards God. And he gives example of Plutarch. He says, if you say that I never existed, I will be happy rather than having bad opinions about me. That I would be eating all my children as soon as they are born, like it has been said about Satan. And then he says, the bad language when you use that is contumely, and that is a dangerous thing for men also. And what are the advantages of atheism? Atheism makes you free and a simple and a civil man. But religion, you can follow the rules of religion, but you may not be a good person or a gentleman. You may not, because in religion always you have inherent in religion and theism, which is based on that. So religion is based on theism. There is always the possibility of going fanatic, and then that will disturb the states and peace of the land. Therefore he says, whenever there is atheism, the times were peaceful, as in the case of, and you can devote your energies and time for something other, something higher than your day-to-day life, like art and so on. Art, architecture, poetry, then literature as a whole, painting, fine arts and all those things. You can devote that time. But there's no time. You are not using it, wasting it for quarrels. And so you can use it for such kind of things. So he says he prefers that, as was the case, the Rome when it was ruled by Augustus Caesar. So the famous word, expression, Augustan age in English literature, at the time of Dryden, Pope and so on, we call it Augustan age. And also Dr. Johnson, isn't it? Yes. And then he says, the superstition, it overthrows theism and atheism. That's the thing. And then what happened? It catches hold of every arm of the government. It creates problems for life. Who are the makers of supervision? Men. And they are usually fools, according to Bacon, and wise men follow them. And in superstition, whatever, the order is reversed. Reversing the order means, in day-to-day life, what happens is, first there is principles and then practice. In this case, it is just the opposite. Reverse it. First practice and then principles. For example, somebody says that, if you see a black cat, that will be a bad day for you. Somebody saw a black cat, and that day might have been bad for you. And then he makes a theory of it. The practice already started. The other one is he makes the theory. That's why he says a reversing order. Reverse order. Understand? I think it's clear to you. Hope that this, when after reading this of superstition by Francis Bacon, our mind will become clearer. Okay. And then we will be leading a better life than if you are ravished by superstitions. Okay? So see you again. But before that, remember this thing. We are now fighting against Corona. Though in my series, I have been in all my classes, I end those classes after Corona breakout with some message. And this is this week's message for you. Speak not in public. Gather not in public. Wander not in public. Entertain not in public. To protect our private life. That means my life and your life. Hope that you are enjoying my classes. So you share and spend the time, more time, devote yourself to academic life and be alert. Always, whatever way, like for example, washing your hands, using disinfectant, and so on. You should try to protect your life, which is very, very precious. If you protect your life, you protect others' life. Bye. Have a nice day.